feel like getting money. I feel like getting money.
Seven days of the week.
I feel like getting money. I feel like getting money.
Come here, Dustin. Hey, man, it's Jelly Roll, man. We is at the Phoenix Room. My photographer, Dustin, man. Tell about you, man. Mr. I can't say his name. Mr. Clandestine. Look at him walking away, man. God, look at my photographer. Listen, I'm going to show y'all a real manager. This is a humble manager right here. Watch this.
Let's get right to it. I walk inside the spot immediately acting foolish. Bad bitch beside me said that she just want to screw me. I said, I got a camera. Come on and make a movie. I walk inside the spot and then I get right to it. I shut the club down. Now the owner try to sue me.
That's a humble manager for you right there, man. In here helping iron, man. That's a real manager, man. If your manager don't do that, your manager ain't no motherfucking manager. Listen, let me show y'all what's already going fucked up. They tried to give me this shirt to wear. She bought me a green ugly shirt. I left it at the house, though. But listen.
Ain't nothing like a 5X Smiggy.
My mama could not fit in this. I was wearing this size in the third grade. We got to go to Young Stash.
7 days of the week, I've been looking for a come here. I'm just trying to find a little something maybe I can be. I ain't even tripping, keep a secret.
Oh man, Jelly Roll is just, man, my mama named me Jelly Roll. So I went with it. And Fat Man Jones was like an A-list when I was getting in trouble. Like, you know, my homeboy was Pac-Man back in the day, Pac-Man Jones. So the Fat Man Jones kind of went with the Pac-Man Jones. So it was just kind of fun. Totem Pole Roll, see, that's my drunk alias. You know what I'm saying? Like, when I get drunk and I'm, like, happy, when I'm the peaceful drunk, it's like, oh, that's Totem. You know what I'm saying?
I think the thing was, like, the last record wasn't really, like, a single. But Molly was probably my last record that really got pushed like that. And it was an accident. It was, like, a straight fluke, man. It was... My brother Ray really came and told me a story that happened at the club about some Molly, so I wrote a record about it, and I didn't expect it to grow the wings it grew. I mean, it grew virally, but more than anything, like in the clubs, like Molly really got big in the clubs. Like, you cannot go to an urban club in Davidson County right now, I'm blessed to say this, without Molly being in mainstream rotation, like right behind Rick Ross at 1:45, 2 o'clock in the morning, the hypest moment of the club. Like, it's turning that way. It's on YouTube, but it's not a good look on YouTube. You got to go to Worldstar and look it up because they YouTube clipped my video. There was some, like, I guess some real sexual explicit content.
I only got two poses. This one and this one. That's my pose.
Zach had called me, Zach Crowell. He's got a publishing deal with Warner Chapel and Combustion. Good people down there. Shout out to Kenley and Falcon. And he had hit me with a record, man. He said, I got a record. I got an idea. And he sent me a beat and a concept. It was a little bit out of my lane, but it was like, I went in, we didn't write it, we freestyled it and had a blast, man. Like, I enjoyed cutting 7 days. We're planning to shoot the video for 7 days in the next probably week. I think October 1st will be my big campaign with 7 days. Around the first week of October, 7 days will hit urban radio with a mild radio push, and my DJ Smalls mixtape will be in the streets. So.
One more. I want to get you before your hand's dirty, though. So it's cool.
Let me go get help.
You ain't here cutting nothing out for you.
Oh no, you're not.
With the Comcast?
Yeah, I need
to pick up
the payment or
turn
it off.
Holy shit. Did you get that on camera? That sucks. Are you ready?
One, two, three.
Fuck Comcast!
No. You're funny though.
I'm blessed.
Next 5 years. I don't know, man. I just pray it just keeps going, man. I just hope I'm more. In the next year, I'd like to see myself in a situation to really focus on who's with me. You know what I'm saying? Like, we've been branding Jelly for 2 years now in the A-game movement more than anything. And now they've been branding, not me really. I just kind of picked up on railing them shit, the Molly Gang shit. You know what I'm saying? But now it's like, now we're really trying to push, like, One as an artist, and we're trying to push Worm as an artist.
Jelly Labs.
I like him going over there.
That's kind of me, huh?
Yeah.
It's more of you. You got to do your style and struggle to do his.
He's on the smile. Get it out. Get it out. Get it out. Square. Close that mouth.
Chewy
chest in the glasses.
I really do be adjusting because I don't wear them enough to know how they fit.
Check the time.
The Decisions Tour was like, me and Strug was talking, and you know, Strug has had a pending case or whatever. And I've always been real passionate about talking to juveniles because I literally grew up in the juvenile justice center right there on Woodland Street. So it was, I'm real passionate about talking to, you know, misguided youth or whatever. And it was like the Decisions Tour was just a chance for people like me, struggling paper, artists with a name and a buzz and a story, to kind of give back and go to these high schools and these juvenile facilities that I was in and these same group homes I was in and really talk to kids about the importance of the decisions we make today and how they affect you in 10 years.
Speaking about being a role model, what's the message you want to give to these kids that are looking up to you?
I think that's why we called it the Decisions Tour. Was the message was based on, the message I wanted to deliver to people was the importance of a decision we make. Like, 10 years ago, I was charged as an adult from juvenile. I was 17 years old, had just turned 17 actually. I was locked up from quite a substantial amount of time. The judge found it fit to charge me as an adult before I was 18 years old, well before I was 18. And I had an adult criminal felony on my record from that day. I was shipped from juvenile to the Justice Center and put in a juvenile unit. And it was, if I'd have really thought about that decision I made when I was 14 or 15 years old to commit that crime and the effect it would have on me 10 years later, you know, I'd have thought about it different. I feel like kids have, the youth today has a real vision, a real frontal vision instead of a long term. It's just what's right in front of them. You know, think, talking 10, 15 years from now, to me as a 15-year-old kid was, you know, unbelievable. But as a 27-year-old man sitting here, 26-year-old man, it's like, okay, wow, I'll be here when I'm 46, God willing. You know what I'm saying? So I'm thinking different. And it's like, I just want to try to help kids see the importance of their decisions, man, and the hopefulness and dedication and hard work. I mean, I just want them to see the victory. Like, you know, you got to see that a lot of these kids think they're going to die. They're living to die. And that's a sad thing to do, man. I lived like that for so long. And if I wouldn't have lived like that, I would probably already be in a better place in my life. It's just I caught on later that was like, I really have a chance. Like, I know a lot of people right now, 24, 25 years old, that are just waiting to die, man. They're just living every single day of their life like today could be the day they got shot and killed. I'd like to start the 1st of October. I'd like to start sooner, to be honest. We've already got a couple schools inquiring, and I think what's holding us back now is the only thing preventing the Decisions Tour from starting tomorrow is they're building the website this week, and my guy and my PR firm is going to do a big push on it. And you know, I mean, it's a lot of clearances we have to clear. As y'all know, I mean, I'm an ex-convict, so they're just not, you know, it's a lot of hurdles we have to jump, but we know we got God on our side, so we're going to jump them hurdles, and we're going to get in them high schools. Anywhere. High schools, juvenile facilities, group homes, basketball teams, football teams, you know, anywhere y'all want us to speak or anywhere we can come talk and do a Q&A, a question and answer, or, you know, get a platform to really, you know, even if it's just fellowship with the kids, man, if we can just come out to a practice or something and throw the ball with them, like, we just want to show, we want to give back to the community and to the kids. And I know a lot of times my music stands for one thing, but that's my experiences, and that's what I know. But I also know that the real message that I have for kids is bigger and broader than the spectrum of my music, and I just like to be able to touch them like that. Whenever I was a kid, I wish I'd have had a me. I wish, you know what I'm saying, like, it would have meant so much to me if the high schools would have let, you know what I'm saying, Rude Awakening come talk at my high school, or let Pistol come talk at my high school, or let Cool Daddy Fresh come talk at my high school, because I'm bumping Cool Daddy Fresh every day, I'm bumping Pistol, I'm bumping Haystack. So if they would have came and stood in front of me and said, hey man, what are y'all, you know, focus, like, this is important, like, how much different my life would have been just to have somebody I related to talk to me. This is real magic.
What's up, baby? Good.
How you doing, man? They said 7 days sound good, man. I ain't got to hear it yet. I'm trusting y'all's here. Y'all see that, man? Look at that, boy. Jelly Roll first photo shooting. The real OG came through.
Hey, we rolling?
Yeah, you live.
Hey, man. Hardest working man in the rap business in Nashville, Tennessee. Right here, by the Jelly Roll. Trust me.
Humble Giant, baby. That's cosign from the best. I ain't say it. Well, that means something coming from one of the few in the city that got something.
Right now.
Yeah.
7 days of the week. I like his look when you do that. He's kind of funny, right? No, that's me like being cool. I mean. Square. Chin up. Head down. Turn it completely to the side. You can get playful, man. It's cool.
I'm being pretty playful right now.
Oh, you playful?
I mean, with that, I mean, that's the playful as I get before I just really start having fun.
Got it.
You got a lot of pictures of me just really having fun.
That's cool. But just to be real, the main ones that I wanted, like that vision, we nailed those. Just to be real. Yeah, now all that you have to do is nail the outside.
I can't wait to see those.
That's funny. That's fucking funny. He looks like the fucking
I can't see the picture yet.
Yeah,
still.
That's funny.
When do I get to see all the pictures?
Never. Nah, you get to see. They know the rules. They know that the client.
December 3rd, Nashville, Tennessee, Limelight, Jelly Roll birthday bash. It's going down, man. It's going to be huge, man. We're going to shut the city down that night. We got some big names coming through. We're not dropping them yet because we're still working on it, but we're for sure doing December 3rd at Limelight. You know the team will be there for sure. You know what I'm saying? I know Stack will be there. I know Bubba will be there. I know Paper will be there. You know what I'm saying? Shout out Bubba Spark City Paper. I know that for sure. You know what I'm saying? Worm, One, the whole A gang, Molly gang. Like, I mean, it's my birthday, man. You know what I'm saying? It's going to be a good night. I hope I did it for a reason. You know, I guess it'll probably be I hope I did it for a reason. You know, and that's it, man. Fuck, we had a blast. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. It depends on what kind of deathbed I was lying on. You know what I'm saying? Or fucking rail help me, you know what I'm saying? Call a doctor, depending on where I was at. But no, I'd probably be like, man, I hope it had an impact, man. You know what I'm saying? Remember me. I might just leave with two words, just remember me.
Hey, what up?
I feel like getting money. 6, 7 days of the week. Hey, how you doing? Let's get it right.